Most of us cook, well, if we cook, in given and prefabricated kitchens. Kitchens that are composed out of modules, 60 centimeters deep, 6 centimeters wide, 110 centimeters high, and repeated all along our walls. This is created by an immense kitchen industry that has flooded over the world. How can we, even with all its background and all its incredible intelligence that's inside, and all its incredible economy that it has been developing, how can we still improve it? What can we imagine with those blocks? Can we update that? Can we maybe imagine that our kitchens become more clear, more clean? Because at the moment, I have no clue what is inside these boxes. Where is my pan? And I don't know how dirty or dusty it's inside, even if it's meant to be hygienic and fresh. And I don't know how many products there are in my fridge. And if they are in good condition. And I don't know how the pipework is doing. Is it cluttered? And don't we need to repair it? Or how is our waste system, if it is there? And can I separate the different types of waste? Can't we not make that more clear? Can't we make that not more transparent? So that somehow I can monitor all this processing better? And if we imagine, let's say everything is transparent, clear and clean, doesn't it then mean that the only thing that is colorful and visible is our food? And doesn't it then imply that we encourage to love the food and that maybe it even becomes more healthy, if not sexy? So can we imagine where all these things are simply more transparent? Where we can indeed look into this pipework to control it? Where we can see all the products when all these doors are somehow open. Where our sink is transparent so that I can see how the water is going through it. And where I can see how my waste products are selected and how they are positioned in the correct trash bin. That's why we propose to test this transparent infinite kitchen, where all these elements are tested on its visibility, or its invisibility better, its transparency. Yes, the shelves, an easy part. Yes, the doors, a very obvious part. But also the top, which gives a kind of deep view to its interiors. Also the cooking plates, so that temperature can be also combined with transparency. And the fridge, but I can see the products. The dishwasher, not yet possible, but also on my shopping list to get it one step further. And then the pipework, the cranes, and the trash bins. From the ecological components to the plastic components, I can see them. And I hope and dream also about the pans and the cutlery, so that we all can see actually the food, the products themselves, which is the core of the operation. And we can see our hands, and we can see how we process and cut those elements. I think that's what it is ultimately about in that infinite kitchen, that it encourages food production, that it encourages the processing of it, that it hopes a little bit to make a better cuisine in the end. I see this as part of a wider dream, this kitchen. It is part of an environment, if not a city, that's ultimately transparent and therefore accessible. I mean, imagine that not only our kitchens are transparent, but that the walls that surround us are transparent, the doors, and also the next room, and maybe the neighbor behind it, and if not him only, maybe the next neighbor in that way, that would create infinite perspectives in our cities that would make within our claustrophobic environments possibly a view into the direction of the mountains or the sea. It would definitely lead to a situation which on one hand more public. Maybe for the private parts, the intimate parts, we can find another kind of glass. Maybe a mirroring kind of glass that would even enlarge our perspectives even more. And then we find a combination of private and public. I think that's what we somehow need more in our individualized environments these days.